Fowler made a great defensive play, just taking, stealing that pass from Patrick Kane.
Here's the Brinkett. He dropped it. Zebra shot it. It was tipped wide. Now Schmaltz threw it in front. Shot. They score. What a pass by Nick Schmaltz. That was a wide open net for Alex DeBrinkett. A great setup by Schmaltz. DeBrinkett to finish it 2-0. Murphy. His check. Sharp got in. In front. Here's Hartman. He shoots. Got to save Miller. Rebound. That is deflected in by DeBrinkett. So the Blackhawks third line has scored 3 goals in the game. And the Hawks are up 5-1. Now they're going to have a 2-on-1. Manson goes ahead, gets it into the zone. Wagner with the intended receiver. That didn't work out. And now the Hawks are 2-on-1 the other way. Kane with the DeBrinkett. Kane for DeBrinkett. Hat-trick! Alex DeBrinkett, the 19-year-old. And Patrick Kane had one thing in mind all the way up the ice. Try to get the kid the hat-trick. He did.
And here come the Hats.
They want to get in on our forecheck and wear down our D. It's about executing for the Penguins.
Here's Gitzel scores off the end boards, and Jake Gitzel has tied it. Ron Hainsey took the shot, and Gitzel played the ricochet off the end boards and ties the game. Watched by Foligno. Here's Daly to Gitzel. Power play goal in the series. Shot that went off Malkin. Wide, they score. Big shot, Gitzel. And Pittsburgh has its first lead of the night.
Dubinsky undisciplined on that penalty, and they're going to pay for it. Goes off the end boards once again. I think it went off Malkin and then off the end boards right to Gensel, and almost a carbon copy of his first goal.
Plays it to the near side corner. Crosby arrives in behind the net. The Crosby line causing some problems here. Scores! Gensel! Goal number 3 is the game winner in game 3. Jake Gitzel with the hat-trick goal. And the Pittsburgh Penguins, at 13-10 of overtime, have taken a 3-0 stranglehold on the series. Sid and the kids do it again. Gitzel, Sheary, and Crosby all in. So Jake Gitzel continues his torrid pace and now has 9 goals in the last 8 games. And his second game winner of this series.
Guys, a lot of respect coming from the Blackhawks captain.
Yes. Certainly so. Good.
And a quick shot of the score right off the draw. Philip Forsberg ties it up. And that's why, all the respect.
Blackhawks getting out to the early lead. There it is, at least right in behind off the draw. Smith jumps in. So effective at doing this. Sorry, Forsberg jumps in, supports the battle. And then just a quick wrister up over the shoulder of Darling on the short side. Phillip with his second of the series.
Colin Wilson made this point in our open, Pete. Had trouble finding the back of the net the last 20 games.
Here's Fisher.
Is how you do that. Wow, remarkable. Filtered down to Mike Fisher. I don't know when Fisher has the presence of mind to spot Forsberg out the far side, but a great feed over to Forsberg. He's actually got to change his body position and shifts, pivots to get a great piece of that and beat Scott Darling on the short side.
Dark with under 20 seconds. Intercepted Neal. Put off the board well ahead of Forsberg.
Good job on the back check by James Neal.
And Forsberg puts the hat trick into an empty net.
As the Canucks get to it, Tevis has his shot blocked, and Sam Steele is off to the races on a breakaway. Score! He opened up, Markstrom went 5-hole in the Ducks lead, 1-0.
Oh, great moment for Sam Steele, and you saw the speed. There was actually separation between Steele and the Canucks that were chasing him. Beautiful finish for Sam Steele.
Levo has it pop up, can't glove it down. Sherwood brings it right back, lets it fly. Markstrom leaves a rebound. Sherwood scores!
Sam Steele, John, it was Sam Steele that jumped on that rebound and chopped it into a wide open net. shows good hands and just chops it into the net to tie this game up at two apiece. But
two on the night, three on the year. Hangs on to it as we're under a minute in the period. Brings it down the slot. Boy, this is a patient play here by Anaheim. And now the pass went off the broken stick. And the Ducks bench is upset because the Canucks were trying to sweep the broken stick out of the way, and it went off the broken stick. And now
you're not allowed to sweep a broken stick at the puck or at a player. And if it impacts the play, this should be a penalty.
Chris Lee looks like he has a call, and he's telling Bo Horvat to beat it.
The call on the ice is a penalty shot for shooting a stick at the puck.
A penalty shot.
They're going to let Sam Steele take the penalty shot.
If he were to convert, he would become just the second Duck rookie ever to have a hat trick, joining Bobby Ryan. And his first career NHL penalty shot. Here comes Sam Steele. Backhand score!
Wow.
Hat trick for the Sherwood Park, Alberta native, and the Ducks lead 3-2. We're still in the second.
What a sweet looking move that was.
What a confident looking move that was.
I mean, what a play by Steele. Look at the bench reaction.
What a night for Sam Steele.
Here's Kane trying to set a Kubelik. Oh, got set back later. Rebound, they score. Kubelik got his own rebound. He followed the initial shot and pumped it home. Kubelik with 16 goals his last 22 games, and the Hawks tonight with two goals in 26 seconds, and we're even.
Second chance opportunity for Kubelik. There's one. Failed clear by Cirelli. And Kubelik puts it into the wide open net while on one knee. And the Hawks back in a big way, tie it up at two.
Picked up by Kubelik to Keith. Kubelik's one timer. He scores! Dominic Kubelik with a bullet, his second of the game. The Hawks cash on the power play, and they lead 4-2.
I mean, this pass is right in the wheelhouse of Kubelik. And McElhinney moving right to left. He's out, he's down, and Kubelik goes top shelf. And we talked about it earlier. When he moves laterally, you got to go upstairs, and that's where Kubelik goes. Again, the key.
Over, Saad couldn't shoot it because it would have been offside. Put it for Kubelik for the hat trick. Dominic Kubelik set up by Brandon Saad. Five straight goals for the visitors, three of them by number eight, and it's 5-2.
Right at the netminder, and Anderson, no problem. Another scramble at the side of the net, it's in the goal.
Coach's challenge, goalie interference. Wouldn't that be something?
Upon further video review, there was no goaltender interference. The call now stands for the goal.
There you go. There you go, young man. You got yourself your first goal, and may you have many more. Nice going.
Paling, who scored his first NHL goal, he's on the puck along with Delorier, who's got it back to the blue line. Off the crossbar, score! Paling gets his second goal of his young career. Wow, what a night for this guy. Now listen to the crowd.
Welcome to the National Hockey League.
Right to Kulak, though. Played it carefully to the corner. Up to center with Shaw. He went off stride. Coming in! Score! The hats are going to rain down in Montreal. Brian Paling, a hat trick in his very first game in the National Hockey League. How about a chance for four? Brian Paling, standing old, coming for him. Yes, sir! What an unbelievable start of a career.